everyone. Today we are going to talk about organs on chips, and more specifically the potential biomedical applications of a heart on a chip. Heart disease are one of the leading causes of mortality in the world. Therefore, understanding this disease and developing new therapeutic treatments is becoming a major challenge in medicine. Unfortunately, the usual methods used for biomedicine research, such as 2D in vitro cell culture or in vivo animal testing, are limited. On one hand, cells in 2D cultures behave differently than in a 3D environment provided by the human body. And on the other hand, animal testing are not 100% accurate regarding to the human body response. To control these issues, a new device has been developed. So let me introduce you to heart on a chip. This device is a 3D in vitro environment that aims to create a biomimetic system to reproduce the physiological functions of the heart. To create it, we need a microfluidic chip with BDMS. The chip is made of two compartments, a cell culture chamber and an actuation chamber to apply pressure to the cells. The two chambers are separated by a thin membrane. Inside the chip, we have microtissues. Here it is cardiomyocytes, the heart cells, cardiac fibroblasts for the extracellular matrix, and endothelial cells for the blood vessels. We also need to add microactuators, for example, to send electrical signals or to implement mechanical stimulation to provoke heart beating and pumping. And finally, we also have microchannels going in and out the chip to provide the cells with nutrients and oxygen. This heart-on-a-chip technology is a breakthrough for biomedicine research. In spite of the fact that we are still at an early stage, in the future, heart-on-a-chip could become a powerful tool for disease modeling or drug screening. For instance, we could study specific disease and their impacts on cardiac functions by monitoring the heartbeat, or by observing changes in the biological aspects of the cells. In addition, it will also be possible to test drugs directly in the device, and therefore evaluate their efficiency or cardiotoxicity.